Hello everybody, I'm Zerish, your favorite Dragon Gamer, and welcome to the stream, or video if that so happens to be how you're watching this. Today, we're getting back into The Last of Us, and today is going to be Ellie's episode, because Joel's currently out of commission. And right now, we're hunting a deer. We're going to take the high ground. Damn. See it anywhere? There you are. No. Damn it. I don't want this scene to be longer than it has to be. God. Does she just not have that, like, sight? Right, we got tracks. Very slow. Just need to get a line of sight on it. Ah. bleeding out at least. Slowly. I wish she had the sight. Fuck.
That was a terrible shot.
My bow is probably the least favorite, my least favorite weapon that you can have in this game. And I'm guessing this isn't the same exact bow that Joel has.
There you are.
So all my upgrades and stuff probably aren't even a part of it. Not that I upgraded my bow at all, but... Alright, we just gotta get... slightly closer.
Oh man.
All right, so I got it and it's really hurt. But I'm doing this ring around the rosy in this same area and it's getting annoying. Pretty sure if you try hard enough at some point there's a way to just get that part over with easy without even having to make a second rotation here. Oh, it went a different direction. It just started moving again. Three arrows has got to do it, right?
Oh, you're still alive.
Cause like all this blood, I'm willing to bet that's more blood than a human body has in it. Oh, the second arrow sends it to a different location. See, I don't remember a whole lot of this section of the game and onward. I remember important details, but a lot of the in-between gameplay I forget. Because, like, it's an entire game. How's one person gonna remember every single detail of a game?
Great.
So, like, exactly how to do this scenario is not something I remember. I know I'm going slow, but oh, there's my kill.
Who's there? Come out!
Hello? We just want to talk.
Any sudden moves and I put one right between
this guy.
Your eyes. Ditto for
this guy.
What do you want?
Name's David. This here's my friend James. We're from a larger group. Women, children. We're all very, very hungry.
So am I. Women and children. All very hungry, too.
Well, maybe we could trade you for some of that meat there. What do you need? Weapons? Ammo? Clothes?
Medicine! Do you have any antibiotics?
We do. Back at the camp. You're welcome to follow us.
I'm not following you anywhere. Buddy boy can go get it. He comes back with what I need. The deer is all yours. Anyone else shows up...
You put one right between my eyes.
That's right.
Two bottles of the penicillin and a syringe. Make it fast. Go on.
I'll take that rifle.
Of course.
Yep. Little smart, little smart. Rifle is definitely more reliable.
It's probably gonna be a while. You, mind if we take some shelter from the cold?
Bring him with us.
There. You know, you really shouldn't be out here all on your own.
I don't like company.
I see. What's your name?
Why?
Look, I understand it's not easy to trust a couple of strangers. Whoever's hurt, you clearly care about them. I'm sure it's gonna be just fine.
We'll see.
Oh boy.
You had another gun?
Sorry.
To be fair, you did only ask for the rifle.
No, you have your pistol.
You know how to use that thing.
I've had some practice.
No matter what, we have to keep them out.
Alright, so I literally just have long range.
Cover the windows.
Okay.
Make every shot count now.
Mr. Four.
Keep doing that. Behind you.
Oh boy. Oh right, she's got the butterfly knife. Nice.
You weren't kidding. You're a better shot with that thing than I am.
All right, that's enough. Too much more in this. Yeah, see. Too much more, and that window is completely open.
The
You got that. Okay, so that one's dead. Alright, do any of these bitches have ammo? Yep.
Maybe they followed you and your friend.
Glitched? Ah, shit. Okay, but a bite wouldn't kill her.
Nothing over here.
That's already there.
There's a whole lot of them coming at us.
Oh! Oh, her head went splat. Oh, I need health, like, right now, my dude. Sir, I need medicine. Oh, I got a gun.
Do you know where you're going?
Never set foot in this place.
Oh, great.
It's clear. This way.
Right behind you.
How are you holding up?
You don't need to worry about me.
I am, like, just about dead. Give me some medicine if you have it.
Stay close.
Oh, fuck.
Hey, kid, you all right?
I'm fine.
More clickers. Get out of there!
Do I really? Ah! Okay. Can any of these hit? Seriously.
Thank you.
Okay.
Come on. Door's this way. So close. We need to get there. There. That ladder could work.
Now how am I supposed to get up there? How am I supposed to get it? How am I supposed to? Okay.
Here, come here, boost me up.
Ready?
All right.
You be quick. You keep a look.
I know.
Oh boy, there's a lot of them down there. Spam triangle.
Yeah, it's okay. All right. Here you go.
Come on.
We need to find a way out of here.
Oh shit. Okay, old man.
Whew. Med kit would really come in handy.
There's gotta be a way out of here.
I mean, it's likely this elevator. Oh, yep. Nice, didn't need to craft. Very nice. Nice, Molotov. I'm gonna need a second one of these, just in case.
Keep your eyes open for anything we can use.
See anything?
It's a dead end. How on earth did they use this building?
So what do we do?
We hold out one. Get ready.
Fucking hell.
You hear that? We're on the roof.
I know.
God. Come on. Fuck. I was doing good.
Get ready.
Not fuck, come on. Didn't even see that clicker coming.
Get ready.
Is there any loot on these guys? No. Ah, son of a bitch! I don't like this section of the game.
Get ready.
Cause you're stripped down to the bare minimum.
No.
Oh shit, yep.
The bloater! What? Look at the big fucking guy!
Please have some decent loot.
Hey, kid?
Yeah?
You know, I think we did it.
Like we killed all of them?
Oh, don't sound so disappointed.
More like disbelief.
I'll check the breach.
Oh, thank God, I got a med kit out of somewhere. That was stressful.
No infected.
No infected. What'd I tell you? All right. Let's head on back. Check on that buck of ours. Well, you handled yourself pretty nice back there. I'd say we make a pretty good team.
We got lucky.
Lucky? No. No such thing as luck. Now, you see, I believe that everything happens for a reason.
Sure.
Well, I do. And I can prove it to you. Now, this winter, that's been especially cruel. A few weeks back, I sent a group of men out nearby town to look for food. Only a few came back. He said that the others had been slaughtered by a crazy man.
Oh, shit. Yep, that's right.
I get that. He's a crazy man traveling with a little girl. You see, everything happens for a reason. Get upset. It's not your fault. I'm just a kid. James, lower the gun.
No way, David. I'm not gonna let her go.
Lower the gun. Now give her the medicine.
The others won't be happy about this.
Yeah, well, that's not your concern.
Move the fuck out of the way.
You won't survive long out there. I can't protect you.
Oh, thanks.
Okay, I guess she's in a desperate situation, but there is no way she should be believing she's safe and in the clear, because in reality, she's probably being followed. Mm-hmm. Aoyune! Aoyune! Raided me with a party of two! Woo! Hello, Yune! Welcome! Woo! Raid! Oh, that's a cute emote. How do I get that? I want that. That's a little... It's a little dragon.
Joel?
Oh, I want it.
I only managed to get a little bit of food. But... I did get this. Move your arm.
I don't know how I got a subscription to you, but I got a subscription to you. Oh, that's right. Kyanko gifted it. That's right.
Here we go. Sorry.
It's okay, Joel. You'll be alright, Papa.
Hold on.
You all right, Papa?
You're gonna make it.
You're not gonna die. Uh-oh. That lighting hits just right, though. She looks good. So does Joe. I love the remaster. I have a hate-love relationship with how it makes the two main characters look. Certain scenes, they look bad under good lighting. Certain scenes, they look good under bad lighting. Certain scenes, they look bad under bad lighting. Sometimes they look good under good lighting. Alright, we gotta get out of here.
Are we even sure she's here? Or was she trying to get down the fucking street? She's here.
Yeah,
Get your ass over here!
What are you waiting for? Shoot her!
But David said...
Fuck that!
All right, let's go.
What do they want?
Mm-mm, bitch. Get off. Rest in peace, buddy. I'm gonna murder these bitches. Oh! Kallus, I promise I'm gonna murder them. That's a big-ass gas tank. I don't think y'all wanna be shooting at me. I should be using this. Especially because, unlike when I'm playing as Joel, I am very limited on items. Things I can craft. Things I can shoot. Things I can throw. Very limited. Ooh. Was that a second gun, maybe? No. Alright, arrows. Ooh, shit. I just heard voices. No, damn. I keep thinking it's like rubbing alcohol and grabbing it. More arrows.
You guys, check out the cabin.
Oh boy.
Son of a shit.
Yes, please. I should try and loot these houses. My first time playing through, I don't think I ever did loot these places. Which is something I should really do. Okay, these houses have the exact same layout. Down to the very last thing. Woo! This is a very minimalistic diner. You do not see stuff like this nowadays. Even at Oh shit. Those dudes popped up out of nowhere. That must not have felt nice. Boy. Nothing. Oh. Nice. I don't want to lose the brick.
I'm not getting out of here.
Okay.
He's dead. That is 100% different ammo. But okay. No, I could have gone down that way. Oh, thank you, Yune. Thank you for the raid. Hope to see you soon. Talk to me on Discord. Check my Discord server's announcements. If anyone would like to join said Discord server, hold on. I am going to put the link. Right now in chat. And if you want to join, go right ahead. All are welcome. Nope, those ledges may look climbable, but they not. If you ever hear heavy breathing, it's because of like how much I hold my breath in this game. What's up here? That looks like loot. Oh, it's one of her comic books. How that comic book survived the winter, I don't know. Look at this environment, though. Okay, so how am I supposed to... Very nice. Let's see if there's anything to grab. Nope.
That's the way back. Hang in there, Joel.
Alright, I know for a fact there's about to be people. Really?
Yeah.
Come on, man. Go, pussy.
Is all clear? Yeah. Whew. some sort of loot. None of you. Okay. Damn it. Give me trusty brick. Alright, so I gotta somehow get through this house.
I don't want to get trapped in here.
Okay. I still have spike bombs. I should probably use this. I guess we're full on shivs.
Son of a bitch! Fucker.
I mean, I scared him off. I should use the brick more often, though.
There's the exit.
Ah, shit.
Relax! You're alive here. There you go. There you go.
How are you feeling?
Super.
Here. You should eat. I know you're hungry.
She knows where it came
out
from.
For quite some time.
What is it?
It's deer.
Is some human helping on the side?
I promise, it's just the deer man.
You're a fucking animal.
Awfully quick.
quick to judgment. Considering you and your friend killed how many men?
They didn't give us a choice.
And you think we have a choice? Is that it? You kill to survive. And so do we. We have to take care of our own, by any means necessary.
So now what? You gonna chop me up into tiny pieces?
I'd rather not. Please tell me your name.
You're so full of shit.
On the contrary, I've been, quite honest with you. Now I think it's your turn. It's the only way I'm gonna be able to convince the others.
Convince them of what?
That you can come around. You have heart. You're loyal. And you're special.
Oh.
He's got it on a zip string. That's clever. Sorry, making myself some orange G Fuel.
You are making it very difficult to keep you alive. What am I supposed to tell the others now?
Ellie.
What?
Tell them that Ellie is the little girl who broke your fucking finger!
How did you put it? Tiny pieces.
See, oh boy. Alley. I don't know if I can pause cutscenes without skipping them.
Ellie?
He's feeling fine, I guess. Alright, so, I don't know what I would do in this, in the situation of an apocalypse. I don't know what lengths I would go to survive. However, in the apocalypse, and they're 20 years into said apocalypse, which is further than The Last of Us has shown, basically, so far, like the apocalypse in The Last of Us is only, like, what, 10-15 years? Carl was only, like, 8 or 9? And then they show him grow up to be, like, at least 17. Before, you know, things happen. But I don't know. I can't really judge people for being cannibals in a post-apocalyptic wasteland where, you know, gotta eat to survive. I don't know. I'm pretty sure MatPat did a episode of Food Theory on this. But anyway, Ellie is like 14. Yeah, I'd still consider that a kid, but like, I don't know, the words little girl don't seem like they fit at that point. I don't know. Young woman? Young lady? Like, at least, just, like, girl, period? Just, little girl seems like, 12 and under. I don't know. The wording just doesn't seem to make perfect sense to me. Because, like, when you hear little girl, my brain goes to, like, an 8-year-old. And Ellie's, like, 14 in this game. I don't know. Alright. I do not have all of my gear. She has my Molotovs, medkits, and spike bombs. I also appear to only have the ammo that I had beforehand. 7 seems like it's more valuable. I never got to use the flamer. And I'm not necessarily sure how long after Ellie runs away that this is. I don't know if it's said. Also seems like Ellie might have all the crafting materials as well. Don't be shouting when you don't know where she be. Painted on door. Well, okay, this one has a doorknob. It just happens to be a painted on doorknob. Barred door. Probably can't go in. This one... This section does not want you to loot. Oh shit.
Where is she?
Oh boy. It would be nice if I could form a bomb. Ugh. I really don't like his crouching speed right now. That was a lot. Oh no. Nice. Yep, knew it was going to trigger someone.
You're going to shove off. Hold him still.
Here we go.
Where?
Oh, that's gruesome.
But you're gonna mark it on the map, and it better be the same exact spot your buddy points to. Mark it.
It's right there. You can verify it. Go ask him. Go on. I ain't alive.
I like that they use the clicker sound for multiple things.
I ain't told you shit.
That's all right.
That's the same voice actor for like Ben 10 or someone.
No, wait. Wakey. Come on.
I love seeing Joel as a badass. Ooh. Ellie should start clicking for effect here.
I warned you.
I'm infected!
Really?
So are you. Right there. Roll up my sleeve. Look at it!
I'll play along.
What'd you say? Everything happens for a reason, right?
Can she?
What the hell is that?
Can she spread the infection?
Looks pretty fucking real to me.
Everyone, the internet is very diversified on their opinions here. On whether or not Ellie can act as a contagion.
What the fuck is wrong with these people?
Where you going, Ellie?
Fuck. Come on.
It's locked. I need a gun. Okay.
Med kit, nice. We'll definitely need that. That door was left open, stupidly. Well, I lost the trusty old brick. There we go. Nice. She's freezing this whole time. Because the jacket she's wearing is definitely not appropriate for the weather. Those murders were definitely necessary because I needed the ammo. Oh, I think there's freezing physics in this one. How exactly do you plan on making me pay for it, though? You can't even walk. Yeah, this part of the game definitely, like, has me rely on different strategies.
Situation. We're gonna take care of it.
That's Sam Riegel right there. That's Sam Riegel right there. That's Sam fucking Riegel.
Uh-huh.
Alright, so we need to pick up another bottle. Or brick. Brick works. I think brick distracts more. Or does more damage. Whereas the glass does more to distract. No. Yeah, I should use this. Might want to rely more on the gun if I can't stealth. If there are too many people, I won't be able to do the whole distract and stab strategy. I don't like this one bit. That's glass. Anxiety. Pretty sure I've gone through this entire place by now. The front door, yes. Yep.
How did you do it? That's all right. Nowhere to go. You want out? You're gonna have to come get these keys. No, you're not infected. No one that's infected fights this hard to stay alive.
I gotta get those keys.
So what is it, Ellie? I gotta admit, had me back there. For a second, you shook my face. But only for a second.
Come on. Oh boy.
You know, you keep surprising me.
Oh.
You know, you just surprise me. Hello, Ellie.
Ah, shit. God damn. So where am I supposed to do from here?
You know you can find a girl.
God damn it. Come on, come on, come on, come on, be enough. Oh, fucking course. Yep. Okay, before we get into that whole thing, I need to take a quick bathroom break, and I will be right back. So, if you are here and you want to join my Discord server, keep in mind it is 18 plus, so don't join if you're not of age. The link is currently in the chat of the stream. I'll be right back. Alright, I'm back. There's Ellie's backpack. Yep.
What is this? What the hell is Ellie's stuff here?
Oh. Damn.
Yep.
There she is.
Ellie.
Oh no. I don't want to continue that encounter. Okay, cutscene. I almost put a content warning on this episode because of this scene. Or because of this whole damn part, really.
It's okay to give up. Ain't no shame in it. I guess not. It's not your style, is it?
This is her most traumatizing, like, scene.
You can try begging.
Fuck you.
You think you know me? Huh? No idea what I'm capable of.
Ellie! Stop! Stop!
Fucking touch me!
It's okay. It's me. It's me. It's me. Look. Look. It's me.
He tried to...
Yeah, there's 100% a father-daughter relationship here, and I am all for it. He may not have, like, helped conceive her, but he is very much teaching her life lessons that she didn't know before meeting him. And also, like, they are changing each other as people. Like, without Joel, Ellie would still be a punk kid who is just smart mouth, distrusts everyone, and only really cares about what she cares about. And without Ellie, Joel would still be this hard ass with no sympathy, no care for other people.
What?
Look, hospital. This is where we get off. Let's go, kiddo.
And, you know, it would just be like this whole thing. Like, they have shaped each other in a way that is very profound. And that's part of why I love this game. It really gets to you. There's a lot of emotion there. There's a lot of feeling there. And like, by the time the game's over, you do not want to stop playing, because their story together is so addicting. You just want to see what happens next, and that's why I'm so glad that even though it took them years, they made the sequel. I honestly hope that they come out with new games for the series. There's got to be at least a part 3, because Ellie's story does not end at like the end of part 2 is 100% not the end for her. There is more stuff to do. And I don't know. I feel like there's just more we could see. But anyway, that is where I'm going to end this episode, because there's a whole bunch after this. I think next episode is going to be the end of the series. I think next episode I'm going to go straight through to the end of the game, and then we will move on to Last of Us Part 2, Or no, we'll do the DLC, and then we're gonna move on to Last of Us Part 2, because I did purchase that this month. In fact, it's the reason I'm broke this month. So, segueing, if you want to help me financially, there are connections on my Twitch, Twitter, and YouTube for financial stuff. There's a throne link, which is you can gift me things that I want slash need. I'd prefer if you're going to go that route, you get stuff that looks like it's an essential rather than the like Funko Pops and stuff that are on there. There's also PayPal, which my PayPal link is on my Twitter and on my Discord server, which again, link is in the chat if you're watching this on Twitch. And my Cash App is like $DragonZeris. Also, if you're watching this, thank you for getting this far. Thank you for sticking with me and watching this. I know this episode was a bit emotional. I know this episode it's a bit frustrating for me at the beginning, and then it just gets really dark really fast, and I know that can be triggering for some people, so I appreciate it. And if you're watching this on YouTube, same goes to you. If you like this video, press like. You know, there's that button. And if you like my content, please press that red subscribe button. And, you know, my upload schedule is very sporadic, so I would appreciate it if you press that bell icon right there so you can get alerts whenever I do upload. And without further ado, I'm going to wish you guys a good day. Peace.